right or wrong, like I was talking about yesterday, this is just your interpretation of your right ear with the diagonal left side of the body, okay? And then go ahead and just really take time. You're gonna explore the internal curve, the external curve. What do you think about how you can describe your
You can also take patterns that are on your own body, you can have your fingerprint, observe what it's like.
So take your fingerprint, observe what it looks like. Try to find the pattern and the shape in it. Go ahead and throw out some words. Oblong.
And take another part of your body, for example, what you could imagine to be where your heart reaches the kind of point, this is for example. And by looking at this, then try to move with this internal organ in the pattern that you observe. Now, if I move my hand at this angle, but also try to move that organ at that angle. In other words, every time we're performing a kind of guardian like this, especially in an iterative exercise, you want to keep the angle of the pattern that you're reading absolutely original, otherwise it would be very flat. Yeah. So the fingerprint is here.
Thank you.
Push things, you can establish a line with a gesture. In other words, I can establish a line by making a pummeling gesture. I can establish a line on the floor with little hops. I can establish it by rubbing it into the floor. I can establish by wiping it into the air. I can establish a point by stepping between two things. I can establish a line by making little tiny dots, or between. Two other points. I can probably smear it, swat it, tap it, swat it, kick it. A line or a point is there in space, and how you establish it, how you manifest it, is really up to you. It's very, very important that this part of the process remain extremely playful and extremely imaginative. Don't restrict yourself to a strict drawing the lines like you're drawing with a knife, or a pen for that matter. You have to use the surface of your body and your imagination, about how lines can form and how you can manifest these things with your body and not only as if you were holding an instrument of writing. It's very, very important.
Yeah, I love that. I love what you said about imagination and like keeping yourself open to being playful. And I think choreographers have to have like a really good touch with their inner child. So if you ever have been told that you're kind of over the top or childish, you say, thank you very much. right? Because to be a choreographer, to do what we do, you have to stay really open to that imaginative part of yourself, which sadly, sometimes in adulthood, with all the pressures that we face, can kind of get shoved to the side. So as you do this, you're going to feel extremely silly. No problems there. Just go for it. What we're going to start doing just to practice the technique is I want you guys to choose a body part. I'm going to make arms off limit just so that we don't accidentally start, you know, doing one of these. So arms are off limit. You can choose any other body part you want. I want you to write your name in print, your full name, first, middle, and last, and then write your full name in person. Okay, so just finding that. And if you want to switch body parts around a little bit to try different things, that's great. Some fun ones are like your nose, or like the bone at the back of your neck, or like one of your hip bones, your belly button, right? Little random pieces of the body like that. He had some cool ones where he had two body parts working together, which is, you know, more complex, but if you want to go that route, please go for it. Okay, so let's jump up. We'll work on his scripting, just basic writing.
Different, but it requires the same kind of thinking that owing does, insofar as you imagine their axes extending from your shoulders, hips, knees, whatever part you wish. And from these axes, you produce a U shape. In other words, from this point, I produce a U. Yeah? Let me do the side axis, it's easier to show. From here, up to there. Yeah, I go like that. In Inscription in general, in writing, it's very important to differentiate between movements that are isolated, and are motivated from the end, as opposed to movements which are motivated internally. And the difference is very, very radical, between these two things, because the difference is, if I make a circle like this, it's actually a column from this point. But if I go like this, I'm actually forming a cylinder. And this is a radical difference.
Okay, so I'm gonna pause there and we'll practice a little bit of viewing and owing, but what I love about this specific practice is you will already use this in your choreography, right? The internal and external motivation of the movement. Being able to verbalize that to your dancers is a huge skill, and they will understand you much better if they know, hey, just like he was doing, right? This is me rotating. I'm motivated by my fingertip making the circle. Yeah, so we've got a cone. As opposed to doing the same thing, but I'm going from my shoulder, right? Both are a circle of the arm, but they're quite different, aren't they? The way they land in the body. And so when you're coaching dancers, particularly like early professional or even advanced student dancers, who maybe are not keen enough quite yet to just pick that up from watching a demonstration, it really helps. And or when you get old like me and you can't demonstrate every single thing pull out, it's really helpful to be able to verbalize what you mean and where you want their impulse to come from. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and pop up. We're gonna go through some of these. First, I want you guys to just explore ewing and owing. So for this one, the mirror is kind of helpful. You kind of briefly touched on it, but also it just went really fast. But every plane of your body where your body intersects itself is gonna be a T. So that's gonna be where our arm comes in, that's a joint, that's a T. Our hips, right, where we can lift from, that's a T. Our knees, our ankles, our wrists, okay? So you can set up as many T's as you want. The simplest one is the arm. We can see that really easily. So we're gonna establish a line with the arm, and then we're gonna U the arm. Yep, going under, and that's an external motivation from the end of our hand. And then we're gonna U the arm again from our shoulder, okay? So you can just play with that in any number of planes of space and start changing up the body parts.
How do you handle that rotation?
Yeah. He definitely cheats me a little bit. Because, I was exploring the wrist and I was trying to Yeah, exactly.
You gotta like rotate your arm and like move and bend.
Yeah, no, I agree. You have to kind of like start it. You gotta get fancy with it. I know, I'm trying to do the same thing, kind of trying to figure out how to manipulate that joint. But it's fun, and like what I love about it is it doesn't really matter where you get to. It's just like you explored your body, you explored the movement, you explored what's possible, you know? And that's like the win in this. It's not necessarily coming up with anything great, although you might. The win is just like knowing what the body can do on a deeper level, yeah?
Like just a source of inspiration, not really like the final movement itself.
Yes, that's such a great way to state it. Very succinct, Julia. Thank you. Good. Awesome, guys. Okay. Like I said, I think we all be able to like 20 moments, and then if you want to get some of the more advanced ones, so I'm going to move forward. Isometries. So, isometries are kind of one of these big thoughts, and so I want to go through this one. We'll go through a couple more of the videos because it takes a second to kind of understand his concept.
How does this mix? The most important things in this technology is called isometries. And isometries are relationships between forms, you know? And this, for example, how is an isometry, yeah? It's this form is shaped and transferred to a relationship that is, which is, keeps the sense, yeah, of the original. An adjective modification. You'll notice that these things can take place pretty much on smaller axes. In other words, this is the middle of my body beforehand, yeah, in the original model, and now the model is shrunk, yeah, and I have the middle sort of happening here, so this isometry can go here, 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 in the same number of orientations that you had in the original large model. So an isometry is just a form that reorients itself to every diminishing model. So in other words, as far as I'm concerned, an isometry of this is also that.
In this L shape, like they are in the legs, I'm connecting them in opposition. Does that make sense? But you know that any line you create like that is going to look good. Yeah, because they're all based off of the same form, you just translate it into different body parts. That makes sense? That's why that looks good, whereas, I don't know, what else would look good? This. That's not good, right? That's not a great line. Why is it not a great line? Because it's not an isometry when I'm doing my legs. Yeah, I know. This one's like, kind of like, once you chew on it for a second, you start to realize how much of it there is in dance in general.